We welcome you live inside the Raleigh Iceplex here in Raleigh, North Carolina. It's time once again for PAC TV's coverage of NC State ice hockey. I'm Drew Blevins alongside of Brett Galton. Brett, tonight we've got a really good one between two of the top teams in the ACCHL, the NC State Wolfpack, who come in owners of a 5-3 record, and the Wake Forest Demon Deacons, who come in owners of a 7-2 record. Both teams have a single blemish in the ACC. They are top of their respective divisions. This should be a very good hockey game.
Well, it should be a good one, no doubt. Like you said, Wake Forest, 7-2, 4-1. They're top of the Central Division. They're playing some good hockey right now. And then NC State, on the other hand, on the cusp of a three-game losing streak. So let's see if they can bounce back tonight.
Took the words right out of my mouth. The NC State Wolfpack played an absolute thriller against the Maryland Terrapins. They dropped it 4-3. That was after Sam Banishevitz made it a one-goal hockey game with 37 seconds to go in that one. And then NC State forfeited away a 2-1 lead in the third period. They allowed three unanswered goals. I'll get it right eventually. The semantics aren't important, but the fact is this was an NC State team that was shorthanded, that dropped a couple of hockey games, arguably that Georgetown game they really should have won. What does it take for them to rebound here tonight?
Well, they got a couple of injuries again today, so we're going to see some new people inserted into the lineup. So we're going to see if they can try to get some momentum and get this NC State team back on track to their winning ways.
One of the major storylines is going to be that Joey Hall will have the start tonight in arguably what has been the biggest conference game so far of the year for the Wolfpack. Mike Gazzillo is saying it's no schnub against Calvin Stone, but he does want to give Joey Hall an opportunity to continue his great play. Hall had 48 saves against the Maryland Terrapins. What do you make of the move?
I think he's starting to get his groove. He's starting to make some good saves, so I think he's just going to continue this against a good Wake Forest team.
NC State's going to want to use their defense tonight. They have an entire forward line of all freshmen. It seems like, once again, it's going to fall onto the blue line to stop Scott McKean and company on the Demon Deacon defense. What's it going to take for NC State to get the W here tonight?
Like you said, they got some freshmen, so let's see if these freshmen can step up and play some good defense. And NC State needs to get going quick to get some goals and then just cruise from there.
Good old-fashioned in-state rivalry time here from Raleigh. The Demon Deacons and the Wolfpack next on PAC TV. Crisp, cool fall air is the normal outside at this time. Raleigh, North Carolina is enjoying its final glimpse of summer weather before spring will roll around next year. It will be almost 80 degrees tomorrow. It touched 70 here today. However, we're gladly trading in the warm weather outside for the cool, crisp air of an ice rink here tonight. The Wake Forest Demon Deacons and the NC State Wolfpack, Drew Blevins alongside Brett Galton. Sit back, relax, and enjoy this one from the Iceplex in Raleigh. The Wolfpack are in their traditional black uniforms, red block S crest across the chest, white numericals, red and white trim, black socks. The Demon Deacons are in their old gold uniforms, black trim, black numericals, and a quick shot just wide of Corey Colangelo to start things off. The Demon Deacons are in gold socks with a black trim. NC State has possession across the blue line. Banishevitz winds up and fires a slap shot deflected by Colangelo back out into his blocker side corner for the first whistle of the hockey game. Interestingly enough, the NC State Wolfpack did have to make yet another change on the top line. Jack McDonald was injured, did not play last weekend on the Maryland road trip. Owen Drugan is playing in the center of the top line. They've got a good chance there from Banishevitz on the slap shot, not to mention a pass right to the front of the net that nobody was home for. The Demon Deacons, one of the better teams in Wake Forest history. As we see a puck hop up out of play there. They're 7-2 coming into this hockey game, 4-1 in the ACC, which is unprecedented for the Demon Deacons. This was a team that handed NC State its only ACCHL regular season loss last year on February 12th in a 7-6 thriller from Winston-Salem. Breakout to the far side. Andrew Kristoff sweeps it up for the Wolfpack out in neutral ice. Backhands at the blue line. It was cut off initially. Good reach forward by Mueller, but he never got a quality stick to it. Provides a little body check there. Jostles the puck free back for Ryan Zipitelli. The junior defenseman banks it across for John Coquelinburg, who's become a fan favorite so far. Largest player on the team by body mass. Mike Kren might be the only one who could rival him in overall size. State sends the puck down, rolling into Colangelo. He deflects that one off for Ciccini. He'll skate it up the far side of the ice. A little touch pass blocked off by Andrew Kristoff. He gives to Coquelinburg. NC State has the pass intercepted. This is dangerous. It's McKinney. Shoots one. Deflected. The rebound. Joey Hall puts it into the corner. Scott McKean was not the guy you wanted to turn that puck over to. Dan Weaver buries a shoulder into his man. That was McKean. Jostles the puck free. NC State gets it across the blue line, but not too much further. Ben Walker takes it here for the Demon Deacons. Dumped into the zone in back of Joey Hall. Chased down by Ryan Lensmeyer. He's rubbed out, but State has possession. Kicked around at the blue line. Held in nicely by Robertson as he works it down in toward Joey Hall, who reaches out and covers the puck. And that will give us a whistle with 17:49 to go in this first period. Brett, so far good pace to this game, but NC State is still lacking a neutral zone presence. What do they have to do to be able to gain the offensive zone with possession?
I like the pace so far that they're doing right now. And as we alluded to in the pregame, Joey Hall is going to have to make some good saves, and that was already a good one right there. So that's a good sign for NC State so far. But they've just got to keep up the pace. They haven't really had much possession right now, but hopefully they can just get possession and go forward.
Back and going to work on the puck. Lost possession. You can see out there, he's in the red Georgia Bulldog helmet, native of the great Peach State of Georgia, the Atlanta area. Vanishevitz gets the puck at the red line, crosses with a pass to Jimenez, touched along, and NC State's offside. It's a good pass by Vanishevitz. He's really tried to work on his passing game and disseminating the puck instead of trying to do it himself, scoring. And I think after a frustrating weekend in Maryland, he's going to be out, and he's going to be looking to make a giant impact.
I think he's just going to try something, to find something positive. You mentioned earlier that they were up 2-1 against Georgetown and then kind of just being shorthanded, they kind of lost that lead. So they need this game to try to bounce back. As we said in the pregame, they're on the cusp of a potential three-game losing streak, and you said you couldn't really find any information on that, but you don't think it's happened
If I'm not mistaken, it has not happened in Mike Gazzillo's tenure. And the reason I say that is we have records dating back to when he came to the team in 2011. And I couldn't find anything back that far. And that was after about an hour and a half's worth of research. Velillo touches along to Drugan across the blue line. Drugan has moved out to the wing. Mike Gazzillo said, it's been interesting watching this line practice. You're probably going to see Drugan play center about 25% of the time. Luis Jimenez will be in the faceoff circle mostly on this top line. Vanishevitz with a touch pass wide of Drugan. It rolled into Colangelo, and he touches off. Pass intended to go up for Sweeney there, but it's deflected offside. So far, you really do have to like this Demon Deacon team, though. The pace they're playing with, the effort they're giving, all that has culminated in a very nice start here. This is the 10th game of their season. And when you're winning over 70% of your games coming into this one, you've really got to like that statistic. Andrew Kristoff off the near side end boards. Chased down, Danny Fredenberg tries to sweep it to the front, but he never got a good stick on it. Backhanded along. Here comes McKean, driving his feet through. Had it on his backhand. He was triple-teamed on the puck. The bouncer's taken by Farhat. Out for Kristoff. Pass is deflected by Trevor Incledon. Always a dangerous player for the Deeks. NC State will break it out from their offensive zone. Farhat has it. Pass intended for Kenny. Went behind him, and Clinton's going to chase this one down. Puck's going to beat him to the goal line, and that'll be icing against the Wolfpack. Fresh legs for old gold and black. NC State has to keep the same unit out.
For the Wolfpack, I think they need to have a little more better passing. Their passing hasn't really been crisp. They've lost the possession in their offensive side of the puck, or offensive side, and Wake Forest has had some good chances, so they need to clean that up.
Bouncer off the draw, taken by the Deacons. Down low it goes. Good body check late. Is that puck jostled free for a moment there? Eric Webb in the vicinity. To the point, Robertson fumbled with it across the blue line. He'll wait for everybody to touch up. Dumps it back in. Last person to touch was Ben Walker, and that's going to allow NC State to get the line change they wanted. Pass for Mitchell Gallagher. Deflected off of the backhand blade of his stick. Wake Forest in the neutral zone, loses possession. Far out with it, a backhand pass out in the middle of the ice, turned over once more and shot back into the zone by Mueller. State has not passed the puck tremendously well so far, as that one shot by Chris Wing up and out of play into State's bench. We'll get a face-off out of neutral territory once again. Kind of surprising, though, for NC State. They've gotten a couple of their older guys back, guys that have played in the system a little longer, and so far these first 5 minutes of hockey just haven't been impressive, Brett.
No. As I mentioned earlier, it's just the passing they're losing. The passing just has not been crisp at all. They've kind of came out of here pretty slow, and you wouldn't really expect that after a couple losses there in Maryland. You wouldn't really expect that, but they just haven't came out with the intensity you would have expected.
Well, State's going to trap Wake in their defensive zone, finally backhanded out by Hank Hartong. Rolls in toward Joey Hall, short of icing, so NC State has to continue to play it. That shot right up the near boards, rolling on the kick plate. Hartong back to get it. On his stick, touches along Joe Macy. Working on that left wing, has to drop it back. Hartong there to save him for now. Wake will work on the opposite side. Touch too long, and here comes Sarasi, but he lost the puck. State, once again, chance to break it out. It's another intercepted pass out on the red line. Skated back in here by Tyler Potts. Here he goes, revving his engine. Shoots one onto Joey Hall. He takes it in the crest of the uniform and gets a whistle. No rebound, 14:02 to go in the first period. And see, this is the interesting thing about this Wake Forest team that nobody's going to tell you. They've got this nice little combination of returning guys, but also new players who are able to come in and make an immediate contribution. And I think that's one of the reasons you're seeing them be so successful.
Yeah, and they don't look intimidated at all. They look pretty comfortable. But the good thing for NC State so far is the goaltending from Joey Hall. He's made a couple good saves. He looks comfortable back there. So if you can take anything good away so far from the sloppy start, it's his play and goal right now.
Well, it's the freshman line out there for Mike Gazzillo and company. Brady Perro, Matt Costigan, and Eric Johnston. First shift of the game. Johnston fumbled it in his skates, swept weakly onto Joey Hall. He steers it aside up at the blue line. Brady Perro has it, trying to get a pass to Costigan off of his skate. Potts takes it. Could be one-on-one if he hurries. Back on him is Lensmeyer. Shot through the goal crease. They scored! Somehow that pinball through the legs of Joey Hall, and the Wake Forest Demon Deacons have an early 1-0 lead.
And the sloppy play continues for NC State. Nothing really Joey Hall could do right there. It's just too many Wake Forest Demon Deacons in the area. It got a little congested there, and great job by Wake Forest right there.
That goal will go to Potts in the number 44 uniform. And how fitting, the Winston-Salem native scores the opening goal of the game, and NC State has ceded a deficit to their opponent for the second time in three games. That is something they are not used to doing. Banishevitz with the puck on his stick shoots one well wide of Colangelo. This would be a marquee victory for Wake Forest if they could get it, but of course far too early to talk about it now. Jimenez fans on a shot that he had trying to go high glove side. And he never got his stick down onto the puck, so Wake Forest survives State's best scoring opportunity. And it's strange when we're saying that the best chance of the game for the Wolfpack is a fanned-on shot. Just shows you how slow of a start it's been for the Wolfpack. Jimenez right up Broadway, holding, passes to Banishevitz, shoots one off the stick of Colangelo, the rebound sent right back at the net into the glove of Colangelo, and he will cover up. Thing is, when you've got a good goaltender down there at the other end, typically the way you want to score is by getting the goaltender to move, and the problem is Colangelo is so technically sound with his lateral movement that it is very difficult to get a puck by this goaltender. Experienced against NC State, he's played in this rink many times and had success here. Danny Fredenberg starts and stops in the near side corners. Puck shot back up for Reed Farrott. Long wrister blocked on the way through. Fredenberg backhands that one high of the net. Picked back up by the Wolfpack in the corner. Spin pass blocked off by Ben Walker, who's done all the little things right so far in this still young hockey game. Up the boards, Macy hacking at it, using his big frame. Only gets it out to the blue line. Fredenberg holds. Shoots it into the opposite side corner where Ryan Kinney goes to chase. Kinney, pressured, loses possession, and here come the Deeks. Up across center, dumped into Joey Hall, steers it along with his stick, Farhat takes it. Shoots it up ice, Ryan Kinney gets the pass. First long completed pass so far the game for the Wolfpack. Potts takes it right off of the stick of Danny Fredenberg, who comes back and grabs it. Chris Wing, the defenseman, will lead the rush. Shoots one well high and wide on the blocker side of Colangelo. Dan Weaver, old man Riverwalk on the team, the grandfather, as he is closer to 30 than he is 20 down to chase that puck. On the near side half wall, Webb gets it over for Gallagher, drops it off. Weaver, slap shot, fanned on. It was blocked simultaneously. Wake Forest bringing it in the opposite direction. Deeks with good speed through the zone. Just touched along here by Sarasi. Loses possession. State trying to break it out on the far side. Banked off the board. Still in the zone. Gallagher back for Coecklenburg. Touches for Zipitelli. He's pressured. Off the end boards. Gives it back for Coecklenburg. Pass for Dan Weaver. Tipped but not completed. And NC State is once again trapped in their defensive zone. Good forecheck by the Deeks. Shot up on another breakout pass attempt. That one gets caught up in the body of Ben Walker. State just content to throw it into open space. Backhanded along. Here come the Deeks. It's Walker looking for somebody to pass to. Tried to drop it along for Kalouf. It never got to him. Here comes Banishevitz. Ramming his engine up the near side. Goes around the net. He's rocked. Banishevitz with a backhand pass. Tried to get it to Coecklenburg. Shoveling it along. The Deacons have it. Out comes Wake Forest. This is Walker once again. Crossing the blue line. He's got Kalouf out far. Drops it for McKean, who tried to touch along for Kalouf. Good defensive play made by Owen Drugan. Banishevitz works other side. Drops for Jimenez. Across Drugan. One-timer. Great save on the rebound. They scored! Sam Banishevitz lurking right in front of the goal crease. Sweeps in the rebound. We're knotted up 1-1.
Beautiful passing right there. That's what we're more accustomed to seeing with NC State right there. And great job by Banishevitz just staying right there and putting it right in the goal. And now we got a good one at 1-1.
The top line once again is the source of offense for the NC State Wolfpack. Sam Banishevitz buries another goal, continues his scoring streak, stretching it now to 5 straight games with at least a point. Owen Drugan and Luis Jimenez will get assists on that. And for the first time in now 3 hockey games, somebody besides Luis Jimenez or Sam Banishevitz is going to have a point. Owen Drugan will collect one with the assist, and he has been a little spark plug for the NC State Wolfpack. Spin shot onto Joey Hall. He'll melt it down. 9:37 to go in the first period. We're knotted up 1-1. How big is it that NC State gets a response goal fairly quickly, not quite 5 minutes separated from going down 1-0? And once again, it's the top line providing the offense.
I think it's huge because they started off this game very sloppy. You didn't like the way that they were playing right there. And then Wake Forest, they could have easily, after the Wake Forest goal, they could have easily just got down on themselves after losing 2 straight earlier last week. But good to see them come back and get one for themselves. And hopefully they can continue the good play now.
Ryan Kinney skates it up the far side, taken down from his knees, tries to backhand a pass for Kristoff. Here comes Wake Forest, though. Good speed, kicked just too far. He's trying to spring himself forward was Sarasi, who is also starting to heat up a little bit. Fredenberg up the middle, drops for Kinney, shot deflected up and into the meshing out of play by Colangelo. 8:56 to go, first period, 1-1. Decent crowd here tonight on the weekend before the Halloween holiday. NC State football team takes on the Boston College Eagles tomorrow at 12:30 p.m. State looking for their 5th win in football and trying to become bowl eligible if they can grab a couple more victories.
You have your Halloween costume picked out?
I do not. I have not dressed up in quite some time, I must admit.
I agree. I'm not very... the most Halloween.
I can guarantee you that on Monday evening, I will be tucked away firmly in my bed, catching my Z's. Into the near side corner, Weaver corralling the puck. Good job by this third line for the Wolfpack, putting a lot of pressure on the blue liners for the Demon Deacons. Finally, Wake Forest brings it out. This is Potts up the blue line, shouldered off by Reed Farhat, who in turn takes a shoulder in retaliation. Gallagher backhands it along for Chris Wing, sure-handed junior defenseman.
Keeps it on the same side, up in the center to Dan Weaver. He's rocked on the way through. Line change for the Pack going very, very rockily. Shot into Joey Hall. He's going to melt it down. That line change was in total discombobulation for the Wolfpack as Mitchell Gallagher was standing right on the blue line stripe trying to get off and get his next center iceman on. And instead, he was hung out to dry, and NC State there was shorthanded 5-on-2 until that line change got through. Hasn't necessarily been a clean game so far. Has been clean in the fact that we have not seen a penalty taken by either side as of yet, but still a couple of errors for both teams to tighten up upon. Icing called against the Wolfpack here. Next home telecast will be coming at you on November the 12th. As the NC State Wolfpack will host the North Carolina Tar Heels. It'll be rough and rowdy on Rivalry Night in Raleigh. We hope you'll join us for that one, a 9:45 p.m. start time here from the Iceplex. And don't forget to come out and support the Sigma Kappa bake sale that will be going on in that game as well by the NC State hockey team sponsorship. And also, a special event here tonight is Pizza and Pucks with Pi-Fi. So for all the fans who are in attendance, there is pizza that is on sale in the lobby concourse area. Delicious and entertaining night, to say the least, and it's a good crowd out here.
Yeah, you're making me hungry right now.
Kicked up for Jimenez. He works up the near side. Chased into the corner. Good defensive play by Curtis Golden. Haven't caught his name so far. Zipitelli out for Koecklenburg. This has been arguably the best defensive pairing for the Wolfpack, and they're only defensemen 3 and 4, according to the line chart we were handed. Big collision at the red line as the puck hops up and out of play. 7:10 to go in this first frame. It's been interesting to watch these two feel each other out. Easily, these teams are playing each other twice, if not three or more times a year. But it has taken a long time for this game to develop into the struggle that it has. And I think you're seeing two very evenly matched teams. Ryan Kinney goes back behind the net. Danny Fredenberg there to help him out in the near side corner. Walker all over him, helping out is Cecchini. Undersized defenseman, Cecchini goes to work. Still doing battle with Kristoff as the puck is just not moving out of that corner. Finally it does to Macy. He'll spring the former Georgia Bulldog back and shoots one. Nice stop by Joey Hall with a far side toe he covers. That's one for Backen that when you come in and shoot that puck, you're always hoping for a guy to be behind you there for the rebound. Macy was chugging along. He's got a lot of mass to move down the ice. But if that shot had come a second later or that rebound had popped out about 3 more inches, Macy most likely would have unknotted this hockey game. Long shot. Hall collects it nicely. Lets it go for Koecklenburg. To Kinney, who backhands it along. Kristoff will chase it down in the possession of Blake Mueller, the defenseman. Mueller turns with it, works up the far side boards. As to find Cecchini, touches along. Sweeney gains entry into the zone. He's knocked down on the way through by Zipitelli. Turned with here, skated up ice by Weaver. Switches field with the pass to Kristoff, who gains the blue line. Drops it back for Fredenberg. He goes to work. Fredenberg with a pass in front as he had the battle off of Sarassi. Wake Forest takes it. Here's Trevor and Cledden. Long wrist shot. Tried to get Joey Hall high. He scored on him that way before. Hall didn't look particularly comfortable taking that shot off of the shoulder, but he does get it to bounce up and over the crossbar, keeping it well out of the way of the net. Wake Forest only managed 2 goals the last time they were here in Raleigh. Both were high glove side on Joey Hall, one from Scott McKean and one for Trevor in Cledden. Shot into the zone weakly, albeit though, by Robertson. Lensmeyer takes it. Just over 5 minutes to go in this first frame, knotted up 1-1 between the Wolfpack and the Demon Deacons. Battle of the ACCHL's best. Here comes Wake Forest. This is Scott McKean. Buries the head, goes back behind the goal line. Button hooking, goes right back toward the front of the net. A good pass off the stick of Eric Kalouf. He continues to handle. One-timer from the point collected nicely by Joey Hall. 4:47 to go in the first period. Hall remaining comfortable in net as he comes nicely out of the crease there, challenging the shooter, taking away the angle. I think critically right now, though, he's not allowing a lot of rebounds, and that's something Wake Forest wants to capitalize on.
Yeah, he's doing a good job of, once the puck gets to him, he's just collecting it pretty easily. But he did look a little uncomfortable on the high shot earlier, so if I'm Wake Forest, I'm looking to maybe take a couple more high shots. But with 4:30 left in the game, I still don't think they've got comfortable with each other's tempo right now. So it's going to be interesting to see if each team can figure each one out.
Back behind the net, wing breaks it up near side. Costigan chasing it down. Brady Perros swipes it back into the zone. Down for Costigan, shot off the pad of Colangelo. Good chance for that fourth line to make a name for themselves. Derek Johnston was there in case a rebound came. There's a high shot in and out of the glove of Joey Hall. And, Brett, as you alluded to, it looks like Wake Forest is going to try to buzz the tower a little bit here.
And he looked a little uncomfortable in that one, too.
Right back into the zone, Sarasi. We'll see if he tries to elevate. Sealed off by Chris Wing. Hard into the boards goes Sarasi, yielding possession of the puck up to the far side now. State right to the hash marks of the half wall, but they lost possession. Long shot in from Ciccini as he just did get across the blue line. Fire wagon change for the Demon Deacons. Vanishevitz snaps one all the way out for Drugan. Shoots one weakly in onto Colangelo. Gave up a big rebound. Jimenez run off and into the boards. Far out, seals the line, shoots one. That one might have been deflected into Colangelo. Gives up yet another big rebound, but right to his Wake Forest center Iceman. Touched along and into the zone. Just over 3 minutes to go now in the first period. Up the near side, Robertson takes it for the Deeks, fires it up, Jimenez intercepts the pass. It was telegraphed across the blue line, 3-on-2. Jimenez dipsy doodles around his man, shoots one wide of the net. Jimenez, with an excellent individual effort, did everything but finish. Dangerous backhand pass deflected by Macy, but he couldn't get a good handle on it. State will survive that scare. Line changes both sides as Wake Forest takes it. Snapped along. That pass intended to go up for Tyler Potts runs too far for him. And icing called against Wake Forest with 2:38 to go in this first period. And Brett, after these two goals have been scored, not really many scoring opportunities on either side as we're just sort of going through the minutia of a hockey game. Not really a whole lot of energy being produced on the ice right now, it doesn't seem like.
No, it's just kind of been back and forth. Nothing really too exciting has gone on, like you mentioned. Not many... any good shots? I mean, there's been a couple, but other than that, it's just kind of been kind of slowish, sloppyish play.
Wake Forest has done nicely, not allowing mismatches on the ice, so they've held the top line at bay for the most part. Good shot on net, kicked aside by Joey Hall's leg pad on the far side. Did a nice job on the low shot that time, but once again, does give up a rebound. Not a bad one in that case, of course. Up across the blue line, Danny Fredenberg drops for Kinney. He's dispossessed from behind, and a great play by Sarasi, who got his stick wrapped around Kinney. Far side corner, chipped along. Zipitelli's going to get this one at the red line. To Kristoff, who dumps it in. Wake Forest will take it. D-to-D pass, and away they go. This is Mueller. Up at the red line, backhand pass along. Sweeney with a shot, fanned on it, broke his twig, pardon. Koecklenberg shoves off Sarasi. As now Sweeney has headed off to the bench and grabs himself a new twig. Koecklenberg at the blue line. Got a shove into Enkledden, but not before the pass came down the ice for Kalouf. Skates back behind the net, avoiding a diving defenseman shot toward the net. Joey Hall steers it aside, net off of its moorings. 90 seconds to go in this first period. And to be honest with you, Brett, I really can't recall the last time I saw an NC State hockey team be this lackadaisical over the course of a handful of games. Everybody's going to have their bad game. Of course, this was a team that was not very happy with the effort they gave against the College of New Jersey in the Stephen Russell Memorial Tournament, but here it just doesn't seem like these guys have the energy, the stamina, or the intestinal fortitude to be able to battle against good teams. And Kledden, good hard slap shot, trying to find the five hole of Joey Hall, who does not allow it, no rebound.
No, they just don't really seem into it right now. Maybe that's because as our semester, of course, is ending in probably a month, a little under a month or so. So classes are beginning to get intense and everything, but they just don't really seem into it at all right now.
Kalouf went high with a slap shot. It was blocked wide. Looked like a good shot, though, as he labeled it for the upper near side corner. Gallagher shoots one through traffic. It's blocked off. Dan Weaver providing pressure to the backside of Hartong. Turnover at the blue line. Here comes Wake Forest. Could be a breakaway opportunity. Shot blocked. Great back-checking effort by the NC State forward, Dan Weaver. Or pardon, defenseman Matt Velillo. It's a long way down the ice, and I misidentified my player. Excellent play by Velillo to get back, though. This is Dan Weaver. Sends it out far side. He's liking those passes. Wake Forest nearly called for two, and he went on the ice as that deflected off of a skate of a player who was halfway between the bench and the ice. Weaver backhands this one along. The captain, co-captain at this point, Sam Banishevitz, goes to work, loses possession. Wake will work out on the right wing. Dumped into the zone and around the kick plate. Chased down, Banishevitz in that near side corner. He's wrapped up. He's going to get a little bit of help from Velillo. State might just be content to send this out to open space. They are, and that is where the opening period is going to end. Well, if there's something that can be said after 20 minutes of hockey, it's a close hockey game. It's 1-1. But, Brett, I can't necessarily say that this has been a great hockey game. It seems like it's been a comedy of errors more than anything.
No, the 1-1 is probably all the only positive you can take from it. It's been kind of just a lazy, kind of sloppish game. So hopefully it picks up here in the second half, in the second period.
Well, we'll talk a little bit more about what went down in the first 20 minutes with our analysis and adjustments coming up after these messages. 1-1 at the completion of 20 minutes from Raleigh. This is NC State Hockey on PAC TV. And we welcome you back to the Iceplex. After the completion of the first period, the NC State Wolfpack and the Wake Forest Demon Deacons have played each other to a 1-1 draw. Brett, while it's always nice to have a close hockey game, and it's always nice to be covering a game that's tied after the first period, you know, we can say all that about the score, this has just not been an excellent period of hockey to watch. It seems like both teams are a little bit slow. It seems like the passing hasn't been there. And both goals are a little bit fluky. One goes off of Joey Hall's pad, ricochets through his five hole, and that's how Wake Forest scores. And then Sam Banishevitz plants himself in front of the net on a running rebound and manages to fire it in the back. But both of these teams have a lot to work on in this intermission break.
Yeah, like you said, there was just no energy in that first period. There was just, it was kind of back and forth, not many chances. I mean, if you could take a couple positives, I would say the goaltending of Joey Hall. There was a couple good saves that he made, and how NC State came back with a goal of their own after the quick goal by Wake Forest. So they didn't get down on themselves, they scored the goal. But really, those are the only positives I saw there in the first period.
You talked a little bit about the goaltending of Joey Hall, and here's a guy who was assumed to be the backup. Calvin Stone was going to be the guy, and so far this season it just hasn't panned out that way. This is another big stage for Joey Hall, second game where he's had a huge stage in front of him, and so far he's answered the bell. What does it take for him to keep going the way he has been? Because he's in a groove right now, and he's looking very solid.
Yeah, I think he's definitely has confidence right now. I just say just keep on playing the way he's playing, and hopefully his teammates can get some energy going and score goals for him so it makes it a little easier on him.
Top line has produced all seven of the last seven goals for the NC State Wolfpack. That dates back to last week's game against the Maryland Terrapins. How critical is it to find offense from one of the other three lines, though? Because surely the top line just can't win this hockey game alone.
Yeah, they can't do it all by themselves. That's apparent. But, well, they're doing it right now. They're trying to, at least. So the other lines, they just need to get into a groove of themselves, get a couple goals, and try to get this team back on track because they just look kind of lackadaisical out there right now.
That's our analysis portion of the first period. We will be right back with our adjustments portion. And believe me, it seems like we're going to have a lot to talk about. We'll be right back after this first intermission break here at PAC TV. Time to talk adjustments here from the Iceplex in the first intermission. NC State and Wake Forest knotted up 1-1 at the completion of 20 minutes. Brett, I want to start on the Wake Forest side. This is a Wake Forest team that had a little bit of momentum through the first 10 minutes of that period. They were getting more shots on goal. They were generating more quality scoring opportunities. But they seemed to tail off ever so slightly in the final 10 minutes of that period. How do they find a way to get that energy back up?
Well, at the beginning, they had energy. And then kind of they played to NC State's level. NC State really didn't have any energy themselves the whole period, actually. So they just need to get back to the first 10 minutes, as you alluded to, and then I think the goals will come for them.
Well, I'll be quite honest with you. I thought Wake Forest was the better team through the first period because they were generating scoring opportunities. They were actually putting shots on the net and testing Joey Hall, a goaltender who has risen to the occasion. Corey Colangelo down there for the Demon Deacons, though, he's playing once again another ho-hum, excellent hockey game, which seems to be the norm for him. Let's talk about the Wolfpack, though. Offensively, a couple of scoring opportunities. They converted on the Banishevitz rebound goal. But other than that, it just really hasn't been fun to watch this team try to generate offense.
Yeah, it just doesn't look like they want to be out there, honestly. After the Maryland trip, they're probably a little down on themselves right now. But you would have thought they would have come out here in the home crowd and got a little energy. But you're just not seeing that from them. So they need to pick up the pace a little bit, get some possession, move forward, and act like they actually want to be here.
We talked a lot about Joey Hall, but Corey Colangelo has been very good as well. Do you think either goaltender has an edge so far?
Not really. I mean, Corey Colangelo does right now because NC State really hasn't put any shots on him, but Joey Hall is playing good, so I think they're kind of equal right now. We haven't really seen what Colangelo is capable of, but we've kind of seen what Joey Hall is capable of so far, so it'll be interesting to see how that plays out in the second period.
20 minutes in the books, the middle frame coming up next here on PAC TV with the score NC State 1, Wake Forest 1. This is NC State Hockey. Puck drop of the second period is next. Quick puck drop here in the second period. 1-1 the score, all knotted up. Wake Forest and NC State doing battle here in Raleigh at the Iceplex. I'm Drew Blevins alongside of Brett Gault, Banishevitz, and the top line out there for the Wolfpack once again to start the period. This will be skated up, though, by Walker. He takes a hard tumble into the boards. Banishevitz will chase down the puck as best he can. Wing dumps it into the zone, and Kledden will go back for it for the Deeks. And Kledden dispossessed. Rare miscue by him, but he's got his defensive partner back there to bail him out. Pott sends it up the boards, held in by Wing. Shoots one through traffic. A bouncer. Colangelo made his save with the toe. Albeit I'm not so sure if that was entirely necessary, as it looked like it was ricocheting toward the outside of the net. Wing clears it to the far side. Wake Forest takes it. Here they come. This could be an opportunity. The Deeks drop it back. Here's Potts on his backhand. Went back to his forehand. Shot it right into the shin pad of Chris Wing. Drugan. Backhand pass. Sealed off by Potts, who's been doing yeoman's work. Gets to Banishevitz to Jimenez. Rolled off of his stick. Banishevitz took a shot on the way through as well as he got lit up by Mueller. Koechlenberg holds the line. Back for Banishevitz. Wrist shot. Never came off of his stick. Back for Koechlenberg. He sends a shot. Knuckleball sky high up in the air out of play. 18:25 to go in the second period. Still scoreless. Nice to see the Wolfpack get a little bit of offensive energy there in that last sequence. But once again, passing hasn't always been there. And now shots are getting blocked.
Passing hasn't been there. But at least we see a little more energy here so far in the second period than we did in the first. If they continue that, I think the passing will come.
Koechlenberg bounces a shot through, pinball to the last defenseman for the Deeks. He sends it down on the fresh ice. John Koechlenberg gives it over for Ryan Zipitelli. Up the boards it goes. Fredenberg couldn't play it forward enough. Sarassi in the near side corner. He's rubbed out. Koechlenberg takes it. All the way around, just out of the outstretched reach of one of the forwards out there. I believe that was Robertson. Up the boards goes. McKean rolled off his forehand. Back to get it. He's backing, but Has to give it off to McKean once again. Good forecheck by the Wolfpack. Back into the bright red helmet. Rolled off by Fredenberg. McKean chasing Zipitelli. Gets a shoulder to him, but couldn't jostle the puck free. Turned over. Here's a chance. Shot. Rebound is there. Joey Hall collects it. Excellent scoring opportunity on the doorstep for the Demon Deacons. But they cannot convert. Joey Hall out on the top of his goal crease, ready to make one of his better saves of the night.
Yeah, another great save there by Joey Hall. Continues to stay very solid there in goal.
And I think what you're seeing here is Joey Hall is slowly but surely winning that number one job. His teammates are taking the vote of confidence in him. Calvin Stone is going to get a start at some point during next weekend's road swing. Whether it be against Charlotte or Virginia Tech remains to be seen. But it'll be interesting to see. Stone played a much better hockey game against the Georgetown Hoyas than he had in the games prior. But Joey Hall's efforts have been rewarded with a big start here tonight for only the sophomore goaltender in the 33 uniform. Through the middle is Walker. Lifts into the zone. Banked up and off the boards. All the way down, and Kledden will chase it. This is icing against the Wolfpack, 16:48 to go. Brett, have you really seen the pace pick up considerably, though, from the first period? I mean, it's still looking just a little bit slow out there.
Yeah, not really. It's just been the same kind of slow, sloppy-ish game that we kind of saw in the first period, and it's kind of interesting because I thought for sure the coaches would have got to both teams there at in the intermission and got a little yelling in there, but it really hasn't worked at all.
Well, with that shot, Wake Forest is now out shooting NC State 19-11 on the game. A rare position for NC State to be stuck in, as normally they are the ones dictating the shots on net category. 16:37 to go, second period. Hall has been equal to all but one. Colangelo has been equal to all but one. Stretch pass intended for Drugan, batted down to the glove of Kledden legally. He's got it, and Kledden shoots one high. Scored! And Kledden goes upstairs near side, 2-1 Demon Deacons.
And that was what we talked about earlier, is them going high. Joey Hall earlier in the first period had struggled with the puck going high, and there it is right there. That's the second goal there for Wake Forest.
Banishevitz tried the spring pass for Owen Drugan, who was parked out on the left wing. And Kledden cut it down legally with his hand, walked right up, and from about three good strides beyond the top of the faceoff circle on an Olympic sheet of ice, goes top shelf on Joey Hall, right where Grandma keeps the cookies. Wake Forest looking for more. Joey Hall spreads out on the goal line. That's not in the net. Immediately the official sticks his arms out. Now we'll have a little commotion in front of the goal crease. Joey Hall with a tremendous stop. That'll reinsert him back into the hockey game. Had a little bit of help from Chris Wing, but in the last 30 seconds, the Wake Forest Demon Deacons have seized every bit of momentum away from the home team, NC State. Face off to the glove side of Joey Hall. State cannot clear. Shot back toward the net, blocked off. NC State now going through their own spacing issues. Wing's going to do it himself, up through the neutral zone. Pass bounces around for Fredenberg. Here comes Wake, a bouncing puck in the neutral zone. Chopped along, wristed into the zone. This is going to be the laid-off side. That's going to force a couple of Deacons to touch up. Fredenberg at the blue line, loses to Kledden, gets it back though. Raked into the zone. Fredenberg chasing it down near side corner this time. Good pressure from Kledden, who has really been getting some attention here recently on his prior two shifts. Up Broadway, Sarassi after the puck. Here comes Wake Forest once again. State discombobulated in their offensive zone. That's a rarity. Here's Kalouf. Shoots one. Joey Hall there to make the save. Wake Forest putting on a clinic. Dumped in by Hartong. Take down right at the faceoff circle, a couple of Deacons went down over dubious concerns, under dubious concerns, I should say. Pick back up. Potts trying to do it himself. Shoots one, deflected up at Hall's chest. Rebound. Whistle blows early as Joey Hall goes crashing into the blue paint of the goal crease. Early whistle as that puck was dislodged. He never had good possession of it.
And Wake Forest is going for the kill right now. They can see that NC State is out of sync right now with really no energy at all, and Wake Forest is definitely trying to take advantage of that.
Officials are sending a couple of Deacons back over to the bench. As you're right, that was a really nice strategy by Wake Forest as they were trying to get Encledden back out on the ice under short rest. And you're right. They are just looking to stick a dagger into NC State here. Shot from Potts is deflected off of the blocker of Joey Hall. State breaks it out only to neutral ice, though. Eric Webb trying to do it himself. Run into, took out the official in the process. Up and around the near side boards. Gallagher backhands this one along, trying to get it to Dan Weaver. Broken up. And here comes old Golden Black once more. Sarassi shoots one high. Joey Hall is equal to that one on the glove side. No rebound. I think what's more miraculous to me is even when NC State possesses the puck in their offensive zone, it never seems like they have control. Wake Forest has seized the momentum in this hockey game, and for the first time in this contest, we're seeing a team really take control.
It's going to be interesting to see if NC State can respond, because they responded after the first time Wake Forest scored, so we'll see if they can respond once again.
Backen shoots one onto Joey Hall, who's equal to the challenge. Right in that big block S crest. NC State only gets two more home games in this semester. North Carolina on the 12th of November, and then the Duke Blue Devils on the 19th. Bouncing puck, Jimenez takes it. He's got Drugan with him. Two on one. Shoots one. Colangelo makes the save short side. Jimenez crashing to the ice once again. Think everybody on that line wants to be the hero. Jimenez, though, in that case, wisely took the shot. Out in the neutral zone once more. Overworked is Velillo. Backen fakes the shot. Works wide. Good tandem defense between Lensmeyer and Drugan. Backhanded down, Joe Macy tries to get onto Velillo, Pass up for Jimenez. Here he comes again. Beats his defenseman who had no stick. Shoots one, Colangelo there. Lensmeyer turns another one on goal. That's blocked on the way through. Lensmeyer, little shovel job, well wide of the net. State trying to get their right personnel out there. Fredenberg chasing it down. Near side boards, held by Lensmeyer. To the point, wing shot, here it comes, blocked. Wake Forest trying to survive, sent sky high up into the lights. That magically didn't touch anything, so play continues. Wake Forest survives the best offensive onslaught of the second period for the Wolfpack. Hard takedown in the far side corner, weak wrist shot onto Hall. Sensing the need for a whistle, he'll get one. .12-28 to go in the second period. Almost halfway through this hockey game. Have not seen a penalty as of yet. And only three goals so far. Wake Forest with a 2-1 lead over NC State. Certainly from feeling and understanding how good NC State has been recently and how good they have been at home, if Wake Forest pulls this off, it's going to feel like an upset. Statistically, though, and this just shows what NC State is dealing with injuries and new players, this would not be an upset. Wake Forest has one more win in the ACC, and they come in with a 7-2 record. Turned over, here's Potts, shoots one, Joey Hall! Doesn't know where the puck is, but makes a big stop one-on-one in tight on Potts. Ryan Kinney sprints out to the right wing, just dumps it in. And you can imagine that Joey Hall is going to be barking at his defense the next chance he gets, because once again a turnover nearly becomes costly.
He has kept them in this game right now.
Dan Weaver onto it. Skating up ice to Kristoff. Along for Webb. Back for Kristoff. Too far across the blue line. Touch up time. Old man Weaver at the blue line. Gives it off for Webb. He's got into the high slot. Tried to turn it back for Weaver. Turned it over. Here come the Deeks. Sarassi. Hogtied by Farhat. Potts there to touch along. Far side boards. Wake Forest has done a nice job spreading the puck. Farhat's going to get it again. Spins out of Sarassi's grasp. Deeks around another Deacon. Sends it up ice. Gallagher loses possession up in the skates of Incledon. Trevor Incledon has played a very sharp hockey game so far. Here's McKean along for backhand one-timer broken up by a diving Eric Webb. Tabanishevitz. Here he goes, number two, revving the engine. Shoots one, misses wide. Was skating out toward the glove side, sent the shot back blocker side. We're going to get a whistle now as the net dislodged once again. Brett, here's the thing, though, that is concerning me. If you're an NC State fan, you recognize the genius of Colangelo in net, and you've got to understand this isn't top lines out there we're going to score eventually. This is going to have to be an earned goal.
Yeah, especially since they haven't had any possession at all or many shots on the goal. And it doesn't help when they're playing so sloppy because the fans down here aren't really into the game as well. And usually that's what fuels this NC State team, but it's kind of rubbing off on the fans down here. But they just need to get something going on soon or else I think they're going to be in a little trouble.
You take the crowd out of any NC State hockey game and you inherently will have an advantage. And it is a very, very good crowd here tonight. Seems to always be for these contests. NC State is second in the ACCHL in average attendance at just over 500 people per game. The Virginia Cavaliers average 729 spectators. They're tops. Good driving effort here by the Pack. Koecklenburg setting up on the wing. Finally got a pass that skittered up the kick plate for him. It was denied by Walker. Been a little quieter here in the second period. Cecchini gets caught up in a bevy of humanity. Koecklenburg turns with it. Here goes the big boy. Shoots one. And Colangelo takes it right on the K of Wake Forest. No rebound. See, this is the nice thing about having John Koecklenburg, and one of his more underrated attributes is Koecklenburg is one of those players that while, yes, he is a defenseman, he has the wherewithal to lug the puck up the ice, and he's not afraid to shoot it either. It's always nice when you've got a defenseman who is heady enough to know when to take the shots and has the physical ability to take them, Brett.
He's pretty much the complete player that you want on your team. He can do it all, and he's shown that right here in this game. But after a quick spurt by Wake Forest, we're kind of back to the same game that we've been seeing the whole time, just kind of sloppy play from both teams.
Well, and now you would imagine the proverbial balls in NC State's court. Wraparound chance nearly swept into the goal by Valillo as he came very close to lifting it over Joey Hall in the clearing attempt. State survives for now. Lensmeyer being shoved around, and finally we're going to see a penalty called. It was the last shove given by Eric Kalouf that is going to give NC State the power play.
And this is what they need right here. They need a 5-on-4 right now to be able to hopefully get something going on.
It's going to be 2 minutes for cross-checking, but in all of that, they're also going to get Ryan Lensmeyer. So I apologize for riling all of you up, but there will be no power play. We'll go 4-on-4 for 2 minutes.
Just like that.
That one's interesting to me.
Do you know what the call was? Did you see what that was?
Well, I understand why he took both of them. It's a control measurement. I don't particularly agree with that call. Lensmeyer got a couple of shots in earlier in the sequence. The puck went away and came back, and then he was already on his knees, and that final push from Kalouf was actually what drew the call. I think if you're going to make the matching minor call, you certainly need to call it earlier. So there are penalties number 1 and 2 in the hockey game. Lensmeyer and Kalouf off. Matching minors, both of them for cross-checking, interestingly enough. So for side hockey, it's a lot of space to work with. Danny Fredenberg's out there, arguably the fastest player on the ice. Chasing Deacons now, though. Robertson up the near side, holding and looking, shoots one, misses well high, in fact, over the glass as well, out of play. .808 to go in the second period, and Brett, I think you also got to look at clock is dwindling down on the Wolfpack. Yes, there is a whole other frame to go, but this year NC State has not been a third period team. There hasn't been a ton of execution in the final frame. The only exception to that was the Maryland game. But it was a soft third period against the College of New Jersey. It's a soft third period against George Washington and Navy. Very, very lackadaisical against Georgetown, albeit I think that was more of a fatigue factor than anything, having to play 6 new players on the ice.
I don't think they can use that same excuse for today because they came out of the gate lackadaisical. I mean, and they've continued it through here in the second period.
Chris Wing takes it, gives to Banaszewicz. Backhands a long intended for Jimenez. Back out in the middle. Wake Forest will control. Banaszewicz giving chase, over-muscled. Looked like he actually got a little bit more of Trevor and Cledden than he wanted to. Had to be careful not to take the interference call, but officials have been very laissez-faire so far this game. There's your 50-cent AP word for the day. Farhat going after it. Wing shoots one, blocked off immediately by McKean. Banaszewicz holding. All the way outside, Jimenez lost possession, rolled off of his stick. Not sure if that was the way he was holding the twig or more the rough ice. Those two have shown a tremendous amount of chemistry. Jimenez has found Banaszewicz on a handful of occasions and vice versa. Both of those guys have been heart and soul guys so far this semester. This is Jimenez to bring it up. Gets by everybody, but he was rubbed out at the last second by Potts playing nice defense. Good touch play. Bouncing puck eludes Banaszewicz's stick. He's going to get it right back for Jimenez now. 5 seconds to go on the 4-on-4. Pass behind Koecklenburg. Backhander blocked off at the skates. Banaszewicz holds the line. 5-a-side we go once more. Banaszewicz backhands it along. Cut off by Potts. And he has just been everywhere so far in this second period. Nearly made it 3-1 at one point. Here he goes, Potts on his backhand, out and toward the slot area. Lensmeyer takes him down, help from Kenny. Potts, with a puck on a string, finally gives it off. This is Walker, shoots one well high of the crossbar. Outstanding individual effort from Tyler Potts. This one's backhanded all the way down, tipped off of a Deacon's stick on the way out. Swicing is waved. Over for Walker. He'll get pressured by the fans. Cross-corner dump in. Good pressure from Backen, but he couldn't quite get to the puck. Soccered ahead. This is Kristoff with it. Sends it across for Fredenberg, who is tied up with Robertson. Functions as a cross-corner dump in. Fredenberg on his backhand in front for Kenny. Shoots one. Blocked off by Colangelo. It goes behind the net. Good chance for the Pack to Ryan Cipitelli. He shoots one. Blocked off. Good seal play by Mueller. He's had a good blue-collar game thus far. Wake going in the other direction. It's the Wolfpack who come away with it, though. Wasn't an excellent offensive effort from Kalouf out of the penalty box. Here's Kenny with a puck in the slot. Shoots one. Good stop by Colangelo. The rebound, and he got that one, too. Another one. Blocker stop by Colangelo. And you know, State fans are looking at this and going, oh, my goodness, it's just ho-hum for Colangelo. This is what he does on a night-in, night-out basis. Cipitelli, out of neutral ice, is going to take it. And Brett, finally, you get a chance to see just how good Colangelo is in net.
But I like the opportunities that NC State is actually getting right now because they're actually getting shots on goal instead of the previous last period and earlier of this period they haven't been. So at least they're getting shots on the goal, and if they keep on going like that, I think eventually one will go in.
Webb shoots one on to Colangelo. He gloves it and hangs on. 4:45 to go in this second period. If you're Mike Gazzillo, are you feeling any angst yet, even though there are another 20 minutes to go in this hockey game?
Yes, because you just haven't had it tonight. You just really haven't had the energy. But I like what I'm seeing here in the last minute or so, that they're moving forward, getting some shots on the goal, and they're testing Colangelo, and obviously he has been up for the test thus far.
This is Potts once again, tried to get up through the middle. He was denied access. Chance for the Deeks nonetheless, though, as a good shot came in from Sarasi. He grabbed the loose biscuit and just came walking right up Broadway. Far side, excuse me, near side boards, rather, as Sarasi turns it back in. McKean uses the boards, but sent a little too far. Reed Farrott with it, pressured from behind. Beats his man with his feet into open space. Farrott trying to go coast to coast. He's still got it. Shoots one. Colangelo safe. Rebounded a bevy of humanity in front. Out for wing. Slap shot. Blocked. Got it back in toward the slot. Good battle from the pack. 2-on-2. Here come the Deeks. McKean with the puck. Buries the shoulder. Here he goes. Shoots one high. Scored! Scott McKean deposits it in the bank. 3-1, Wake Forest.
Just 2-on-2, made nice move right there and just went up, upper right, and just a beautiful goal there by Wake Forest. And now NC State is a little troubled being down 3-1 and not really even being much into this game.
Grandma keeps the cookies on the top shelf, and Scott McKean just found them. 3:49 to go in the second period, and now I do think you are experiencing a little bit of panic if you're wearing red, white, and black. We talked in the pregame, NC State has not dropped three straight in the Mike Gazzillo tenure. The last time they dropped two in the ACCHL was the 2013-2014 season. That year, the Pack lost to Georgetown in the ACCHL Admirals Cup title game. Tipped along, Drugan gains entry into the zone, but without possession. NC State has been down a pair of goals before. There's a huge hit by Coklinburg as he nearly sent one of the Deacons back to Winston-Salem. We'll see if a penalty is going to come of this. That's technically a legal collision, but that's an 18-wheeler hitting a smart car right there. All seems to be well. Top line out there. Pass intended for Banaschewicz. Broken up. Eric Kalouf goes back behind the net. Button hooks back toward the front. Rolling puck on him. He lost possession. This is Zipitelli trying to break it out. No chance there. Kalouf establishing the offensive possession. Here's a shot onto Hall. Rebound still hanging in the slot. Banaschewicz pulls it away. Pass up for Jimenez. Uses his speed and beats out Cecchini. Jimenez, backhand pass. Banaschewicz shoots one, blocked off. Rolling puck on him, never got a great possession. Coklinburg up for Banaschewicz. He looks skyward as he misses a pass.
Looked a little frustrated right there. Put his head down after that one.
Banaschewicz overskates the pass to back into Kalouf. Slap shot Joey Hall there. No rebound. And if you're in the number two uniform for NC State, the word of caution that I would be giving you is you show too much emotion out there. As a team leader and the guy with the C on your sweater, your attitude affects the rest of that bench. And if he's going head skyward, slamming sticks, the rest of the bench is going to do the same. 2:26 remaining in the second period. The Wake Forest Demon Deacons are taking the NC State Wolfpack to task in the middle frame. They're up 3-1. Potts wins it, shoots one right into the glove of Joey Hall. Crafty play by Tyler Potts as he cut himself free.
And if you're NC State right here, you're just trying to get out of this period 3-1 and then try to regroup and hopefully play your best hockey there in the third period.
If I'm NC State, I'm playing no holds barred for the last 2 minutes plus here. Be nice if you could get out of this period at 3-2. Here's Kristoff. Puck gets caught up at his skates, but he kicks it along to his stick. Velillo to Ryan Kinney. loses possession in the neutral zone. Lenzmeyer going out, trying to run Joe Macy. And Cledden's going to go back and chase the dump in. D-to-D pass. And see, this is the thing about it. Wake Forest has been allowed to break the puck out so easily from their defensive zone. NC State's forecheck has been non-existent in the second period. Mike Cozzillo talked about he worked forecheck, backcheck, special teams, and five-on-five in an all-around practice last night. The effort hadn't been there tonight, though. Sarasi dumps it into the zone. Chased down by Chris Wing. Sarasi turns it to the front. Nobody home for the pass. Back to receive it is Mueller. Up the boards, McKean. Touches along. Intercepted by Wing. Dumps it in, and he's going to go chase. Webb has the puck in a little bit of space. Overskated, though. Right back up. Here's Potts. He's got it. Along for Sarasi. Shoots one. Great stop by Hull with the blocker. That could have been a dagger. Minute to go in the second period, and NC State has once again gotten trapped in their defensive zone. Wing. Behind the net. Up for Kristoff. He's got it near side. All the way out wide. Into the zone. Here's a shot right onto Colangelo. No rebound there on the Webb shot. 37 and a half seconds remaining in the second period. And I will be very intrigued as to what Jeff Wing is going to divulge at the interview coming up at this second intermission. Because I get a feeling that Mike Cozzillo is about to go Brooklyn, New York on his team in the locker room. And that is a storm I would not want to be caught in the middle of.
I think he has every right to. By the way, his squad has played so far.
Cleared out. Joey Hall is going to try to draw an icing, and he will with 22 seconds to go. That's a smart play from the state goalkeeper. Brett, though, I've got to ask you, are you surprised at what has gone on here so far?
I am surprised. I thought after the bad weekend for NC State last weekend, I thought they were going to come out here with some energy and in front of a home crowd. I thought they were going to display what we're used to with NC State hockey, but it seems like after last week, after last weekend, it's just kind of taking it out of them, and it's shown here today.
This is a talented team. This is a team that has enjoyed success, and it harkens to memory the phrase, to whom much is given, much is expected. A lot is present on this NC State hockey team, and the expectation has not been met. Horn sound signaling the end of 40 minutes of hockey, and the Wake Forest Demon Deacons are dominating this game. They're up 3-1 with only 20 minutes remaining. Brett, sum up what we just saw.
Well, we saw what we saw from NC State in the first period, just lackadaisical, not much of energy. We saw a little bit of glimpses there in the second period of a couple shots on goal, and you thought maybe they would get in the groove, but they just couldn't do it. And give credit to Wake Forest, because they themselves have played a good game thus far. They've carried the tempo, and it shows on the scoreboard with it being 3-1.
The Demon Deacons are 20 minutes away from securing the ACCHL's single largest upset in quite some time. But the NC State Wolfpack have 15 minutes of adjustments and 20 minutes of hockey left to determine the outcome of this one. We'll be right back with our Coach's Corner interview and analysis and adjustments coming up at the second intermission. This is NC State Hockey on Pack TV, bringing you into the pack. Joined by Chris Wing. I apologize, Coach. I know, you know. He's been a sure-handed defenseman. I'm joined by the assistant coach, Jeff Wing. There is a relationship there, by the way. But Coach, all joking matters aside, this has been a hockey game that has just not gone the Wolfpack way so far. What's going on out there? What are your feelings?
We're a little sloppy. I mean, it all comes down in this game. It all comes down to shots on net. We were outshot almost 3-1 in the first period. It was 9 shots to 1 halfway through the second. So we kind of made a mention of that on the bench. So it was about an even, 9 shots to 9 shots in the second half of the second period. So they capitalized on one of them, but we're now at least even on shots. So we stabilized a little bit. Now we just needed, you know, to step it up.
When you're looking at Corey Colangelo in that Wake Forest net, very good goaltender. He's been good here for a while for the Demon Deacons. It makes it that much tougher to climb the mountain. How are you finding a way to put a couple in on him now?
Well, he's a good goalie, but he's leaving a lot of stuff really close in low. So all we need to do is get those rebounds. You get that first shot like any goalie. You get a first shot and get the second one, and you're more likely to get a goal. So that's the plan, the second
minute. Seems like once again that the passing game just hasn't been there. The breakout hasn't been great. Yeah. Not a lot of neutral zone presence. But Coach Mike Gazzillo told us that it was a good practice. Everything was firing on all cylinders yesterday. Do you think there's any reason, rhyme or reason for the change?
You know, I think the second goal was a long pass, right? So there's what we've been working on and we'll continue to work on is the probability of connecting on a pass. Your success on a pass on a 10-foot pass is a lot higher than an 80-foot pass. You notice the second goal was an 80-foot pass. They intercepted it, came in and scored, right? So I think just the really you got to focus on is the first pass. We're getting better at that, the first 10-foot pass, but then there's nobody there for the second one. So we're kind of starting to put it together. We just need to get that first and second pass, get out of our zone and play in their end.
This is a team that has a good leadership core. A lot of the guys who missed the Maryland trip are back. Danny Fredenberg's out there. Sam Banishevitz has the C on his sweater as well. Who are you looking for to step up and take that leadership role? Don't you dare say Chris Wing again. We all know he's going to step up and be a leader on the blue line.
I know. Honestly, that first line has been amazing. You know, I think in a game like this, we really do need to look to actually, there's a new guy, Owen Durgan, skating with Luis and Sam. So I suspect we're going to score early with that line, and then we're back into it, and everybody contributes.
Coach, thanks so much.
All right, thanks, Drew.
That is a guy who is cool and calm under pressure. We'll talk analysis and adjustments next on PAC TV. And we welcome you back to the Iceplex here. Drew Blevins alongside Brett Gault. Time for analysis and adjustments here in the second period. Now that we've all sort of calmed down a little bit, and now that we've assessed the situation, and I think Jeff Wing is a great diffuser of tension. He really is. That's a great demeanor to have there in the locker room. Still two-goal hockey game, but there are 20 minutes of hockey left to go. This is the exact same situation State found themselves in against Maryland, against the College of New Jersey. They're not a stranger to the situation, but still you got to feel like that they're trying to find that edge in the first 5 minutes.
Yeah, I mean, two-goal game, it's up for grabs right now. I mean, they could easily get back into this, but the question is if do they want to? Because they haven't looked like they want to play at all this game. They've been sloppy. The passing hasn't really been that great. You saw the captain, Sam Banishevitz, him even put his head down. And so everybody's just kind of out of sync right now, and Wake Forest has taken advantage of that.
The side note that I noticed, and the one I think is the most detrimental to Wake Forest's success, is as they were skating off for that second intermission, the Demon Deacons were high-fiving, celebrating, smiling. I think that's a very dangerous thing to play with because at the end of the day, this is still NC State hockey. Largely, they've been the king of ACC hockey for the past 4 years, and there's still 20 minutes to go. How does Wake Forest stay focused and locked into this game?
I mean, they keep on playing their game. They've kind of taken this game into their own hands. They've controlled the tempo. They've controlled the shots. They've controlled the possession. They've really controlled every asset of this game and just continue to do that, and they'll have the game in the bag.
The Deacs are certainly going to have no issue resting back on Corey Colangelo's ability. He has just been simply tremendous across his tenure for the Wake Forest Demon Deacons. But if you're Colangelo, you know that everything, including the kitchen sink's about to be thrown at you. How do you prepare for that?
Well, Jeff Wing mentioned earlier that he, when they have the low shots, he's kind of letting rebounds be available. So NC State needs to take advantage of that and be right by the net and put those rebounds in the goal.
It's going to be a fun final 20 minutes. We're coming right down to the wire once again. The score at the end of 2, the Wake Forest Demon Deacons 3, the NC State Wolfpack 1. Puck drop in the final frame is next.
SBA.
Welcome back to Raleigh. We are knotted up in a battle between two schools that have been perpetually pitted against each other. Wake Forest was initially founded by the State Baptist Convention of North Carolina in the 1800s in the town of Wake Forest, North Carolina. The university officially moved to Winston-Salem in the year 1953, part of a general phase-out program. Right now, they're up a pair against the Wolfpack. Quick shot on by Jimenez. Colangelo was there. A lot of history between these two teams. In the sport of football, they are the longest continually running football game that is played in the ACC every season at now well over 105 meetings continually. Banishevitz out wide for Jimenez. This is a good pass. Shoots one wide of Colangelo. He might have got a piece of that. Banishevitz rims it in down low. Jimenez chasing after it. Forked free. Barat sockers it along, holds it in, banks it off the end boards. Jimenez will chase down Encledon. Encledon spins out of trouble. Yeoman's work by Sam Banishevitz here. He goes after it. Run in too hard. Huck jostled free. Here come the Demon Deacons. Jimenez in the neutral zone. Takes it here. He's got Kristoff behind him. Shoots one. Blocked off immediately. Mueller sends that one up and ahead. Koecklenburg holds the line. Shoots one. Rebound loose. Banishevitz lost by a step. Good pressure to Mueller. Jimenez holds the line to Banishevitz. He shoots one. Denied. Banishevitz taken down hard on the play. Now he's grasping into his knee. And this is not good.
That is not a good sign for NC State.
Banishevitz immediately collapsed to the ice, and he is writhing in pain. That is the heart and soul of this NC State hockey team. And Mike Gazzillo is out to attend to the best player in all the league, and it is stunned silence from this crowd. Teammates surround Banishevitz. We will keep an eye on this while staff gets out there to tend to Banishevitz. We're going to cut to a commercial break. We'll be right back on PAC TV. And now it is a nervous panic that falls over the atmosphere here in Raleigh. Sam Banishevitz was helped off the ice from the neutral zone down toward the state locker room, which is at Colangelo's end of the ice. And Brett, he could not even so much as put an ounce of body weight onto that. Practically carried off the ice. At least he could glide on the one good leg. But that did not look to be anything positive for the NC State Wolfpack, and the way he went off the ice, it has you thinking that it's not something that he's going to be over in a week. This could be a long-term deal.
No, I, like you said, he couldn't put any pressure on it at all, as we see a trip right there. Good sportsmanship right there, but he just couldn't put any pressure on all, and there goes your heart and soul of this team. And if you're NC State right now, you're playing for him.
Well, Mueller is going to take a seat in the box after he had a very borderline collision with Danny Fredenberg. Mueller recognized it immediately and went over to Fredenberg and apologized for the hit. Which it was good to see that. I would have been very, very worried for how these remaining 18 minutes would have played out if there hadn't have been that showing of sportsmanship. Mueller is going to head off for roughing after that collision. And NC State goes on the power play, but this is going to be, once again, a shorthanded unit without Banishevitz, who's normally out there playing the left point position. Wake Forest clears to start it out. And Mueller's very fortunate that Fredenberg didn't receive any type of long-term effects, because if he had, that is a penalty that could have been a major. Kristoff bounces it along. Drugan can't hold the line, cleared by the Demon Deacons. And now, Brett, I really do think you've got to look to the other guys on your team that have been here before. It might even have to spawn from a defenseman. To Fredenberg on his backhand, lost possession.
Yeah, somebody's got to step up now. Banshevitz has had a pretty good game. Him and Jimenez have been pretty much the 1-2 punch so far, but that just means somebody's got to step up to the plate right now and try to lead this team.
All the way down the ice, Joey Hall will set this one up on its tee a minute ago in the Mueller penalty. Up ice for Jimenez. Hop to stick. This is going to be icing. And there it's whistled. For NC State now, the name of the game is not only comeback effort, but it's resiliency. And this is the one monkey wrench that nobody expected to be thrown into the equation. If the score stays the same, it's not going to diminish Wake Forest's accomplishment. But shadow of doubt will creep in. The best player on the ice, either side, arguably, heads off. I don't think there's any hope that he's coming back for tonight's contest. Shot out wide. Here's Jimenez. Up the ice he goes. Across the blue line. Shoots. One. Scored! Nice. Luis Jimenez! 3-2! And it's a hockey game now, baby!
And we just,
Luis Jimenez!
And we just said somebody needed to step up, and Banshevitz and him have been the 1-2 punch, as I just alluded to either earlier, and he steps up right there, and now we got a good hockey game, and NC State is right back in this game.
Just at the time you needed a guy, Luis Jimenez is that guy. Not quite to square one, but a step closer, 16:39 to go third period. And now the name of the game might be Feed 25. Costigan and Kinney will play out there with Jimenez for now. The other thing this does is it completely diminishes the top line. Now two-thirds of that line out. Costigan works far side. Stops, pops, drops for Kinney. Kinney takes it. Fumbling himself over sticks. Kicks it back over in front. Good defense by the Deacons. Farrott. Run into, good hit from Potts. He and Farrott getting into it. We're going to see icing called here from the back linesman. Wake Forest does not get a line change, and Joe Macy is clearly frustrated at something out by the Wake Forest bench. And I think reality just hit for the Wake Forest Demon Deacons. This is going to be a dogfight for the last 16 minutes, Brett.
Oh, yeah, it's going to be huge. That goal just was huge from NC State because after seeing Banashevitz going down, you just didn't know how they were going to respond, but you like the way that they responded right there.
Bouncer up on the far side boards. Wake Forest pulls it down. Lift it up. Weaver looked like he got a hand to it, but couldn't get good possession. Here's Velillo. Steps in front of Macy. Dan Weaver's got it. Looking toward the slot. His pass fanned on. Sidesteps a hit. Spun back toward the front off the side of the goal. Here's Lensmeyer through traffic. Colangelo blockers it aside. Velillo holds the line. Dumped in further. Dan Weaver going after it. Mueller run into by Weaver. Webb shoots one well wide. Picked up by the Deacons. Macy intercepted by Velillo. Here he goes toward the slot wide. Great chance in front. Velillo had a nose for the net. Weaver picks it up. To Mitch Gallagher. Lensmeyer shoots through traffic, deflected. Here's the shot, blocked again. Mueller with a big takedown, no penalty. Webb, far side corner, run into by Bacon. Now the bodies are starting to fly a little bit. Mueller, the takedown of Weaver. He's slightly slow to get up. Lensmeyer will go chase the puck down. Demon Deacons are going to get a line change here. Gallagher brings it into the zone, goes out of play, 14:40 to go third period, and Brett, for the first time all hockey game, we just saw an NC State extended offensive possession.
We saw energy. That's what we saw. There hasn't been any energy the first two periods, but after that goal, it kind of has lit a fire under them, and now we're seeing some energy, and we're seeing NC State hockey like it's usually played.
We're going to get a quick stoppage in play here. I believe the scores table has run out of game pucks. So assistant coach Jeff Wing is going to frantically scurry through his satchel of subjects and find some game pucks.
You ever seen that before?
I have, actually.
Really?
When you're around the game practically since the day you were born, you've seen a lot. I tell you what's the funniest thing I've seen with pucks, though. I've seen somebody knock a slap shot right off the goalpost and the puck split in half.
Really? How many game pucks are given
at
the start?
Normally five to the scorer's table, but we've seen quite a few hop out of play here tonight. NC State would love to find a way to have as many game pucks go to the back of the net, but we're locked in a tight one. Big hit, and we're going to see another penalty call here. I believe that's Joe Macy. Pardon, it's Trevor and Cledden, and he's going to go off for tripping. For the casual hockey fan, you might not understand why that's a tripping call, considering it's normally a stick work penalty. Well, if you clip a player like that and you upend him, as in Cledden did there, you can be called for tripping. And NC State will have a golden opportunity to tie this hockey game. In Cledden off for tripping, 14-18 to go in the third period. Interesting now, bodies are starting to fly. I think Wake Forest is in a little bit of a panic mode here. NC State is garnering momentum. Costigan, after the puck, Potts tries to clear, he does. And Reed Farhat's going to want to take that step up closer. He could have held the line there. Jimenez at the blue line. Backhands low. Kinney for Jimenez, one-timer, blocked. It should deflect it off the shin pad of Walker instead. Jimenez's shot went right off the toe of his stick. Costigan takes it here. Here's a shot up high. Colangelo pins it up on that blocker's side shoulder. No rebound. 13:39 to go in regulation play. Capitalizing on the power play has been something NC State has never struggled with. This is a very, very good special teams unit. Kinney wins for Jimenez. He'll direct traffic from the wing, now to the point, shoots one through traffic, up and out of play. You're going to say it hit Colangelo instead of one of the other State players in the area, so that keeps the faceoff low. Now you're just starting to feel some of that nervous tension of a good hockey game building up. Into the corner it goes, swiped at and cleared by Wake. Deacons have had a nice effort on the penalty kill tonight, though.
They have
had to kill a lot.
It's kind of a good feeling that you're getting right now. NC State is, they definitely have the momentum right now.
Here's Fredenberg in front, the one-timer fanned on. To the point and wide.
Yeah, but they, like I was mentioning, they definitely have the momentum right now, and the shots are coming.
On the backhand in front, swept at Colangelo with a pad save, and the rebound, Wake Forest has it, they clear. Mere inches from tying the hockey game, 30 seconds to go, and a penalty to Incledon. Danny Fredenberg trying to elude McKean, he cannot. Just ran out of real estate, good body positioning by McKean. Up the ice, wing off of his backhand. Mueller wasn't expecting it. Gets a weak backhand up, finished off by Kalouf. 9 seconds remaining in the power play. Up ice, McKean upends Webb, sends it right back down into the zone. The power play yields nothing for the Pack. We're even. 12:10 to go in the third period. Straight up the near side boards. Jimenez into the middle. Bouncing puck. Ryan Kinney will chase it. Good ceiling motion by Cledden, protecting the puck. Behind the net he goes. And Cledden, skate this one up. Pass off the inboards. Turned over to Velillo. He's going to snap it right for Weaver. Into the zone. Webb's going to chase it down. Runs too far for him. Colangelo collects it and covers. All of these fans have stayed. If anything can be said, they've been entertained in this third period. Hasn't been pretty the whole time through, but now they're rooting for their Wolfpack to find a way to pull out another goal. Critical faceoff win here for the Deeks. Sweeney dumps it into the zone. Potts will chase it down. Lensmeyer beat him to it. Good breakout on the far side. Up the ice comes Mitchell Gallagher with that long reach. Got it across toward Weaver. Just short-armed him, though. Bouncing puck in neutral ice. Lensmeyer has Villillo and finds him. Up ice. Gallagher chips it into the zone. Weaver's had a nice third period so far. Doesn't win the foot race there, though. The body positioning from Gallagher. Villillo's got it. And we're going to see a penalty called by the back official. He's going to get Gallagher here. I'm going to guess he's going to say that was interference. And I might be inclined to believe him. Yep. 2 minutes for interference on Mitchell Gallagher. Only the second penalty the Wolfpack have taken tonight. And no, it's not a vicious hit. No, it's not one of those bone crunchers, but it's one of those technical things. You got to know when a player is eligible to be checked. There's the rule book wording of that. In that case, the puck's far enough away from the play. The back official makes the call. Wake Forest is going to have an opportunity.
And now we flip the switch right here, and Wake Forest is going to have a good chance to regain the momentum right back from the Wolfpack.
Update from the training staff on Sam Banaszewicz is something that we feared we already knew. He will not return to the ice tonight. It has been diagnosed as an undisclosed lower body injury. If any more information becomes available to us, we'll pass it along, but hockey is one of those sports you get a designated area of the body, upper or lower. Sarassi with a shot, Hall with a save, big rebound, swept away by the pack. They'll kill some time. This penalty is going to work the clock down into single digits. Have about 9 minutes and a little bit of change to go when State goes back even. Wake Forest is going to be content to possess this puck. Mueller works wide of Webb. Good pressure from behind. Wake with some space. Here's the shot, and it misses high. Out of play. That would have been a huge one. And Scott McKean is kicking himself now as he airmails a puck that was labeled for a wide open 4x6. .10:04 to go, third period. That's one that'll haunt you if you're Scott McKean, though.
I mean, he had a wide open net right there and just put it a little too high over the post. Good break there for NC State, though, to still stay 3-2.
Out wide and Clinton snaps it over for Sweeney. He's got it. Drops for Potts, intercepted, cleared, just out to neutral ice. Mueller tried to play it along. He's going to be called for a hand pass here. Went down and tried to baseball cradle it. You see a lot of defensemen do that at this level. And as another teammate touched it, it's a hand pass. That faceoff will head into NC State attacking territory down by Colangelo. 9:40 to go in the hockey game. 28 seconds to go on the penalty. Kenny wins the faceoff. Jimenez looked like he shot that one through traffic. It was blocked. Pass out wide. Wings got it. Slams it down to the other end. Maybe time for one last rush for the Demon Deacons. Ken Cledden's going to start it. Made a good move on Ryan Kenny. Snap pass out far. Here's a shot. Hall with a good save off the chest. Another big rebound, though. Behind the net they go. Potts holding, shovels it to the front. Goes wide. Penalty killed. Five-a-side hockey. Deacons in the corner. Good move in by Potts once again. Puck on the string. Turns it off. Here's the shot. Joey Hall stacks the glove on top of the pad. Makes the save. No rebound. 8:59 remaining.
Big save there for Joey Hall. Keeping the Wolfpack within striking distance. And with 5v5 once again, now it's going to give NC State another chance to regain the momentum and go forward.
Backen's going to take the draw. He's got McKean and Incledon out there with him. NC State's going to break it out. Jimenez from Weaver holding the puck. Good job by Incledon to run him into the corner. Taken down legally. Costigan after it. In Cledden, holding the puck. Jimenez reaches out. It's just floated all the way back. It reaches the goal line. It's going to be icing, but it won't. Lensmeyer behind the net. Steers it up ice. Good pass forward intended for Costigan. He never got a stick on it. This will be icing against the Wolfpack. It's going to come down to being able to have good, crisp passes down the stretch here for NC State. .827 remains in regulation. A lot of nervous anticipation in this building. It just keeps on mounting and mounting. Shot blocked. Jimenez got a shin pad to it, is what it appeared. Lensmeyer chases down the puck, gives over for Velillo. Up into the neutral zone, turned over again. In Cledden. Has it, just taps it along. Velillo jumps the passing route. He's run into. Puck squirts out into center, and Velillo goes down, and he is writhing in pain. Velillo, little bit of a limp here. He's also looking at the shoulder. He'll come off. That's another injury NC State can't afford to have. Another takedown. Joey Hall lobbying for a penalty in the goal crease. Ryan Kinney skates it ahead. Sends it up ice. Pass for Jimenez. Runs too far for him. This is going to be called icing. And it heads all the way back down to NC State's defensive end. Seems right now that Luis Jimenez is going to be the guy that the Wolfpack are going to target. Matt Velillo stays humped over on the bench. That's a defenseman that goes out, which means if you're going to play six defensemen, you've got to bring Brady Parro back. And right now, you're just running out of bodies if you're the Wolfpack. Ryan Kinney heads up ice with it here. Crisscrossing with Jimenez, shoots one. Calancho with a save, but the rebound was a little too close for comfort for the Demon Deacons. That went in and out of his glove, and he dropped it right between his legs. And if he had shuffled any more, he might would have kicked that one into his own net. Well, Jeff Wing said it's just shots on net, shots on net, shots on net. Sometimes good things happen. Costigan, Fredenberg, Kristoff out there now. Wake Forest slams it up the board. Zipitelli holds. Backhanded along into the zone. Kristoff will chase it. Passed ahead by Wake Forest. Here they come at the blue line. Bouncing puck taken away by the Pack. Kristoff through center ice. Across the blue line holds. Shoots one right into Colangelo. He makes the save. Mueller and Kristoff having words. Danny Fredenberg will shove his own teammate away. And the last thing NC State needs is to take an undisciplined penalty here with a fraction under 7 minutes to go. I think this is the line you want out there, but you've got to rotate it with Jimenez's line. I'd say that you're running about two offensive lines, scoring one, scoring two. But naturally you are, because that's about how many people you have left. Kristoff at the red line, works to the far side, shoots one, sizzles it high off of the stanchion, bounces up and out of play. .640 to go. NC State's last ACC loss at home came in October of last year. Virginia Cavaliers beat them 6-4. Stephen Russell Memorial Tournament. Quite some time ago. I believe I actually misquoted myself when I said that, because that would have actually been hovering more around 18 months ago. Officials discussing with the Wake Forest coaching staff. Gallagher will take the draw here. Wingers will be pushed back on that right side. Faceoff won by NC State. Down into the corner. Behind the net it goes, and Clinton picks it up. Off the glass for Backen. Sent ahead. This is Potts. Right into Mitchell Gallagher, who blocks it down with a big frame. Pass gets over for Eric Webb. Artong works on Webb. Weaver, backhand pass in front. Gallagher couldn't reach out in time. Parot turns it back for Dan Weaver. Slap shot through traffic, blocked on the way through. Wake Forest lofts it out to kill time. This is what the Demon Deacons are going to do. It's not pretty, and in fact, it's frowned upon in the game, but they're just going to lop this puck up. It's not going to have enough juice to go down for icing, but it's going to kill some time. Wing forces a turnover. Out into neutralize it goes nonetheless, though. Jimenez for Gallagher. Backhand pass and a weak one. Easily intercepted. Kalouf stops on a dime. Turns up through the middle. Slap shot. Joey Hall reaches up, snares it. Plays it along for one of his defensemen. It's Farhat. Didn't necessarily look pretty, but it got the job done. Pass out wide for Costigan. Runs too far for him. Ryan Kinney for Costigan now. Just across the blue line. Jimenez back out there. 5:18 to go in the third period. 3-2 Wake Forest. McKean ahead of everybody. Shoots one. Joey Hall makes the save. No rebound. Pinning it under his leg pad. 5:10 remains in regulation. You wonder how much gas is left in the tank. If I'm Mike Gazzillo here, I'm throwing all lines to the wayside. I'm getting my top three forwards who remain for me. They're on a line, and my next three. And that's what I'm going with. And honestly, I think you've got to look at your best passing defensemen and putting them out there. Sweeney with the puck for the Demon Deacons. Out into the far side corner. Drugan jumps him, has the puck. Up for Kristoff now. Drugan run into hard. Drop pass for Fredenberg. He shoots one, blocked. Bouncing puck. Velillo's got it. Through traffic. In the slot. Here's a chance. The backhand is wide. Matt Velillo with a good opportunity. Under 5 minutes remain in the hockey game now. Fredenberg sends it up off the boards. This will be Kristoff. Works over for Velillo. Good to see him back out there after a scary hit. He's run into hard. Kristoff's going to chase Mueller here. Mueller behind the net. Hack and whack time. Lucky without a slash, but Wake Forest is going to take a penalty here. This one is going to go against Mueller. And now things are going to get interesting. This is going to be a holding call, and I think they got Mueller. They might not have. They got Danny Fredenberg. That's frustrating. Danny Fredenberg's got every right to be upset about that one. Wake Forest might have just called a timeout, was the signal I just saw, and that means NC State has no lettered sweaters on the ice for the next 2 minutes. Fredenberg is going to go off for holding. You might could have got him for a slash, but that was a good 5 seconds before the arm went up, and then Fredenberg was the one who was tackled by Mueller. That one just doesn't make any sense to me. Timeout called by the Demon Deacons, though. Take me inside the NC State huddle here, Brett. What are you talking about?
Well, you're down a couple men right now, so I think fatigue is honestly, I don't think it's the energy anymore because we've seen decent energy here in the third period, but I think fatigue is starting to set in with the NC State players right now. But if you're Coach Gazzillo right now, you're telling them to just let it all loose right now. You got to move forward. You're going to have to move forward being down one right now. Take shots. And then be right there if for the rebounds. And you hope that there will be rebounds, and then you're just going to put it in the back of the net. But just move forward because you have no choice right now.
Well, the Wake Forest Demon Deacons are going to have 2 minutes on the power play. And if that penalty runs to term and State kills it, they're only going to have 2 minutes and 15 seconds to tie this hockey game at even strength and to pull Joey Hall. The Pack have the timeout in their back pocket. A little too early for them to use it, but off the draw, we battle in the corner. Behind the net, Ben Walker turns with it. Passing around the perimeter. This might be more of a time kill than an actual attack for the Deeks. McKean holding, shoots one, tried to go right through the legs of Ryan Zipitelli, who denied him. McKean to the near side corner. McKean works down low, backhand in front. Joey Hall paddle down, covers up. 3:41 remaining and 1:27 to go on the penalty. Fresh legs for the Wolfpack. 1 minute will come off the ice in this situation. Interestingly enough, they're going to put Ryan Kinney out there with Andrew Kristoff. You see the Mighty Mouse get to the puck, he clears. Colangelo will try to tee it up as best he can, and it wasn't particularly pretty. Harton lost it! Good chance for Kinney. Tried to give it back for Kristoff, but that was interesting enough. A little bit of heartache for the Demon Deacons. Minute to go in their power play. In Kledden, right by Kinney. He's the one who's got the missile that is labeled top corner. Kristoff helps run him off. Backhand pass. Wake Forest, 3 minutes at the top. The pass deflected out into neutral ice. That'll kill a little bit of time. Big hit from Ryan Kinney. In the stay attacking zone, in Kledden, run in too hard by Kristoff. Touches along, and now he goes back for Kledden. And the Demon Deacons look just to be bracing for the final 2 minutes. Up for McKean. He beats Dan Weaver. Sets up shop in the corner. He's got a point man. Fires it up. Here's a shot through traffic wide. McKean has it with 10 seconds to go on the power play. To Mueller. He's holding. He walks. He shoots. Joey Hall comes up with a huge glove save. 5 seconds to go on the power play. 2:20 in regulation.
Great save by Joey Hall there. The defenseman, nobody came to stop that puck, and it was pretty much just Joey Hall and the Demon Deacon, but great stop right there to keep NC State just barely in this game.
Joey Hall has a tactic called baiting, and he wanted Mueller to fire that glove side. Snares that one. Jimenez thrown out of the faceoff circle here. So this will be Webb to take the draw. He wins it back on a good effort. State has killed the penalty. 2:15 to go in the hockey game. Buckle your seatbelts. Here we go. The Wolfpack up in neutral territory. Lost the puck. Chipped along. Wake Forest in front. Chance for Potts goes wide. Danny Fredenberg. It's the stick up, but jostles the puck free. Here's Farad. He's going to skate it. Gives it over. Here's a chance for Webb. Fredenberg's onside. The shot deflects upstairs. The faceoff should be in NC State offensive territory. 1:50 to go in the third period. Joey Hall is awaiting instruction. And now NC State is going to give their goaltender instruction alongside of the rest of the team. Timeout Wolfpack. A lot of nervous tension in this building. The crowd is starting to come back to life here. But they understand the seriousness of the situation. The good news is Sam Banishevitz is propped up on the glass watching the end of this hockey game. It's good to see him in the building and not instead heading to a medical facility, although he's going to want to get his lower body checked out as quickly as possible.
You just hope it was one of those injuries that look a lot worse than they really are. And I think hopefully that's what it was.
I think what you're hoping more than anything is that it's not a ligament. Mm-hmm. Now, I've been hit in net in a similar fashion, and I dislocated my kneecap. That's an injury that takes you out 1 to 2 weeks, not 8 to 10 months. And you're just hoping for the best. Wolfpack out there. The Iron Five for now. Shot deflects up and out of play. The faceoff will stay put. Only 3 seconds run off the clock. Joey Hall is lined up at the top of the faceoff circle. And a clean faceoff win, and you might see Hall jut to the bench. They'll stay put for now. Trouble turned over. Here comes Wake Forest to seal it. The shot, Hall denies him. Game safe for now, but State's got to get it down the ice. Pass ahead, Kristoff gains possession. Drops it back for Jimenez. He works around wide, taps the puck into the zone. Joey Hall goes to the bench. Empty net, 6-on-5. Minute 20 remaining in the third. Jimenez hanging on to the puck here. Tries the backhand pass. Got away! Here come the Deeks to seal it. The shot's wide. Sweeney got ahead of the red line. No icing. Chris Wing sends a pass ahead. It was intended for Kristoff, but he short-armed him. Right back ahead. Here's a chance for Wake Forest to seal it. On the backhand, Kaloop in front. It's wide. Wake Forest establishing possession. NC State back on top of it. Two empty net goals missed. Dumped into the zone. Behind of Colangelo. Kenny and Fredenberg to chase. Breakout pass broken up. Wake Forest clears. It's held for now. Here's a shot toward the empty net. This is wide. Foot race for it. And this is not going to be icing. Or will it be? Was there a whistle blown? And yes, there was, but it looked like that linesman was about to wave it off because Farratt wasn't getting back hustling. This should be an upheld icing. But I believe this officiating crew is going to put this face-off back at center and say it was miscalled. That's incorrect. That is incorrect in that case. Joey Hall is going to come back out, and this is the reason it's incorrect. I'm not just going to say that without backing it up. Since it was by textbook definition an icing, and you're calling it back because you were deeming that a player was not hustling and trying to extend or delay the game, you have to be able to prove in that scenario that the other player would have beat out the icing call. And that's just a poor job of officiating in that case. It doesn't necessarily harm NC State, but they would have liked to have had that face-off in their attacking zone. Officials are going to explain this one out. Wake Forest is going to be very happy about this. They win the draw back in Clendon. Defenseman to defenseman. Clock has not started yet. Now it does. Kaloof. Farratt takes him down. Joey Hall heads back out to the bench. Out wide, pass stretches too far for Kenny, but he skates and grabs it. Into the corner. Kenny run off the puck, 17 seconds to go in the game. Ryan Kenny after it. Eric Webb with a thunderous collision. In toward the front of the net, bouncing puck in front, pass in front, chance right in front of Colangelo, and he's down to cover. 7.2 seconds remain. And now it all comes down to a face-off win. So the face-off actually ended up helping NC State as they're able to get the legs chugging. And that movement momentum allowed them to help their own case. But now it all comes down to this face-off. Kenny tries to win it forward. He's got it stolen right off of his stick. Into the corner it goes. 3 seconds toward the front. No shot comes. The Wake Forest Demon Deacons have upset the NC State Wolfpack. Behold it now. Old gold and black might be for real. They've come to Raleigh, secured a victory 3-2. And for the first time in a Mike Cazillo coached era, the NC State Wolfpack have dropped 3 straight.
It was from the beginning. Wake Forest just seemed like they had it, and NC State didn't seem like they had it. But the third period, NC State got off to the good start, but it was just a little too late for the Wolfpack, and good win there by the Wake Forest Demon Deacons.
Well, the NC State Wolfpack are going to have to put this one in the back of their mind, and they, quite honestly, just have to find a way to remember to play the game. It was not the greatest of efforts through 40 minutes, and the comeback effort falls ever so short. You do wonder about Sam Banaševic. You wonder the status of Matt Vililo as well, as this is a beaten and battered team is about to head out onto the road next weekend. We'll be right back with post-game interviews and analysis. The Wake Forest Demon Deacons have shocked the NC State Wolfpack 3-2 in Raleigh. We'll be back. And we welcome you back to the Iceplex here in Raleigh, North Carolina. The Wake Forest Demon Deacons prevail victorious tonight, 3-2 over the NC State Wolfpack. I'm joined by NC State's head coach, Mike Gazzillo. Coach, I want to get the question out of the way first. Sam Banaševic goes out, stayed at the arena, watched the conclusion of the game. He's hobbling around right now. Any word on his status?
No, not at this time.
When you look at the way this hockey game went, it was a decent effort in the third period, and especially down toward the end, it looked like the guys had some intestinal fortitude, whether it was fighting after the Banaševic entry or what have you. But the first 40 minutes seemed to victimize the team tremendously, and ultimately it looked like that was what cost the team the hockey game.
Yeah, there's no question about that. I mean, I just told them you can't play 25 minutes of a 60-minute game. It just doesn't work, you know, and that was the outcome. So you got to go play 60. I mean, we've done 60. You know, we did 60 against Maryland. I mean, you know, granted, we were down a few guys. We lost 4-3, but I mean, still, we came back from them. You know, from a 3-1 deficit, and you know, we almost tied the game up with 30 seconds left. So, I mean, they played a great game all the way around. We played against Elon. We played 60 minutes. You know, but then you come out and the effort's not consistent. It just has to be consistent.
You told us on Monday that this was the ACC game that you were looking forward to, that this is the one to be circled. Now that you've seen Wake Forest in person, is it just that they're a better team, or was this a lack of effort tonight?
Yeah, I'm not going to take anything away from Wake Forest's effort. You know, I'll never do that. I just don't think that we put the effort in to win the game, even if we did come out with a win. The first two periods just – the effort wasn't there. So, you know, there's nothing really can replace hard work. They got outworked, and you see the score at the end. It's the way it goes.
Top line has still scored all the goals, either been Sam Banaševic or Luis Jimenez. They've scored all 8 of the last 8 goals. What's it like trying to find energy generated from somebody besides the top line?
I mean, there's energy there. You know, you can't you look at, you know, Danny and Ryan are playing well, and Owen Drugan's playing well, and Christoph and Eric, I mean, they're flying around. We're turning down opportunities to shoot the puck, and you can't win games if you're not shooting the puck, and that's pretty much all the way around. So until they decide that they want to start letting that puck go, we're always going to wind up being on the short side of the shots on goal.
And, Coach, you're preparing for an ACC contest against Charlotte next week. You've got Virginia Tech coming up on Sunday. What's it going to be like this week of practice preparing for two very good hockey teams?
We're going to do the same thing as we did on Thursday. We had a really good practice on Thursday. We worked on a lot of things. You know, you can work on all of this stuff, but when it comes down to dropping the puck, they got to be ready to go. They got to want it. And so, to answer your question, I won't know until I see when they drop the puck on Friday night.
Coach, thanks so much for your time.
Yep, thank you.
We'll have the PAC-TV player of the game, Luis Jimenez, coming up after this short break. This is post-game coverage of NC State hockey on PAC-TV. Drew Blevins alongside Luis Jimenez, our PAC-TV player of the game. NC State falls at the hands of the Wake Forest Demon Deacons 3-2 tonight. Luis, you have the goal there to make it 3-2. Was that a little added extra motivation for Sam after the injury, or is that just a shot that you're comfortable making?
No, it had to do with Sam. We kind of got away from doing the little things the first two periods, and once Sam's gone out, we started talking to Coach, and he said just do little things, get shots on net, regardless of where you are, because, I mean, if you don't shoot, you're not going to score. So, yeah, after that, I just took that shot, got lucky, went in, but worked out.
You've been on a hot streak so far for this team. You and Sam have found the team chemistry that everybody wants to be able to find. What's it been like playing with him and being able to score and produce all those points?
It's been great. He's a really good player to play with. We kind of help out each other a lot because I think I'm more of like playmaker type of player. He's more of a goal scorer, so I like to set him up. He likes to score a lot, so it works out.
When you're looking at the makeup of this game, the first 40 minutes were fairly lackadaisical. Things just weren't happening out there on the ice, but the final 20 minutes is the effort that everybody's used to seeing out of this team. What was the reason for the change and the spark, and what's it going to take to have a good start out of this team?
I think it was just a combination of things. We kind of didn't expect them to come out as hard as they were going to, and that kind of made us play down to their level, I guess, which kind of backfired on us in the third period. It kind of took us a couple periods to get it going, and then after Sam got out, they got us going even more and gave us some more motivation. So that's why in the third period we played a lot better.
It goes without saying that losing is never fun, but what's the atmosphere like in the locker room now having lost three straight?
It's a little disappointing. We're hoping to bounce back next week against Charlotte. We'll just focus on doing the little things and just sticking to our game plan, hoping everything works out the way it should.
Well, best of luck against Charlotte, and we'll be down there for the radio broadcast.
Thank you.
That's Luis Jimenez, our PAC TV player of the game. Brett Gault will join me on the other side of this short break, and we'll wrap things up here from Raleigh. For the final time, we welcome you to the Iceplex. NC State falls victim to the Wake Forest Demon Deacons by a count of 3-2. Joined again by Brett Gault here. Brett, I want to start from the beginning, and I want to do our best to analyze this hockey game, because I think what was the most frustrating thing is that NC State on paper is the better hockey team. Wake Forest, though, has been ridiculously hot recently, and they have just been a team that has found a way to win hockey games against quality opponents. They came out and undoubtedly had the better first 20 minutes, played State to a 1-1 tie. But what were you feeling at the end of that first period when you look back on it, because it really just was not quality hockey?
We were just talking to Jimenez, which was the MVP for the Pack, and he himself said that he was not expecting that from Wake Forest. So I think that caught the whole NC State team off guard. They didn't expect Wake Forest to come out like that. And it showed, because they were lackadaisical for the first two periods and they couldn't get anything going, and Wake Forest pretty much controlled the tempo from the get-go.
Wake Forest outshot NC State by a ratio of 3-1 in the first period. They also started off the second period by outshooting NC State 9-1. Wake Forest took a 2-1 lead and then grew it to 3-1. Couple of bad turnovers in the neutral zone lead to both of those goals. Reed Farratt committed a ton of turnovers tonight. Matt Velillo had a few turnovers tonight. John Kochlenberg, the defenseman, getting the puck to the forwards. They were passing the puck too far across the ice. They were telegraphing. I mean, it almost seems like we're talking about very basic fundamentals of the game of hockey that you're taught from squirt and peewee age. And here we are tonight, and NC State really struggled with the basics, and it really showed in the second period.
Yeah, it is basic, but they couldn't complete it. The passes were awful today. They had no possession whatsoever. They didn't have really many shots at all. And credit Joey Hall, because if Joey Hall didn't have the game that he had, it could have easily been more massive margin than it actually was.
Well, Joey Hall stood on his head through two periods, and he had another excellent hockey game again for the NC State Wolfpack. He keeps that goals against average at 3.00 and now four games played, which is going to be one of the higher totals in the ACCHL. Third period, the turning point is where Sam Banishevitz goes out. All we've heard is an undisclosed lower body injury. He will have to be seen by a doctor at some point in the next week, and then they'll determine his status from there. From what I'm hearing and from what it looked like, it doesn't look like a good situation. And if there's any one guy on the team that you could protect and wrap him in bubble wrap, it's got to be Banishevitz.
Yeah, oh, I mean, he's the leader of this team. He's the best player probably in the ACC and the whole. And losing him, losing your soul, losing everything is not good, and it doesn't sound good by the way we talked to Coach Gazzilla about it. I don't think it's going to be a good sign, so that means that they're just going to have to step up, and they did step up in the third period, and it's a shame that your leader going down is the reasoning for you stepping up and playing better in the third period. But hopefully he's going to be all right. He'll probably see a doctor here in the later days, and hopefully it's going to be a good sign.
Well, it's interesting in that hockey game. Luis Jimenez makes it 3-2 with about 16 minutes to go in the third period. And the goal is scored by what Jeff Wing told us, getting back to basics and just putting shots on the net. NC State is going to play the Charlotte 49ers on the road Friday night. And they'll then head up to the Berglund Center and take on Virginia Tech in a non-conference game at 2 p.m. on Sunday. Both of those are meaningful hockey games for both ACCHL standings and also rankings. And depending on what Elon does this weekend, Elon could actually overtake NC State for tops in the Carolina division, which would be a first. Elon is the newest member to the Carolina division as they are playing in their first year in that particular division. Brett, this has been a recurring theme for NC State, though, and I think this is why it's such a disappointing result. State has not played a complete 60-minute effort consistently. If you look at where they've given full efforts, George Washington, I guess you could argue Navy, and Maryland, which was a loss. But when you look at the way this team has played, for the most part, there are wheels fall off the wagon moments that are turning from moments into large sections of the game, and this team is not going to be able to be competitive in the ACC if this keeps happening.
I mean, tonight it's just, there's like head-scratching plays where you're just like, why are you passing that, or like, how is this happening? And these next two games are going to be crucial for them because they're on a three-game losing streak right now, and if they keep on playing the way they're playing, it's just going to continue to keep on downfalling, and before you know it, Elon's going to be sitting at the top there and in pretty comfortable lead.
Well, here's some more staggering statistics for you. NC State only got a win in Charlotte last year by a count of 8-7. That was the first time they had won in Charlotte since 2012. NC State has beaten Virginia Tech at the Berglund Center, but they've only done that once. Virginia Tech owns the all-time series against the Wolfpack, dating back to the days they were in the ACCHL. That means quite possibly NC State's losing streak might not be over. You've got to have a good effort, and you've got to be able to show up for both contests coming up this weekend. The scarier thought is that if things don't go the Wolfpack way, guess what? You've got the North Carolina Tar Heels sitting here waiting for you on November the 12th, a hockey game that NC State has never lost at home with Mike Gazzillo here. Chapel Hill has been very successful so far over the past couple of seasons, making the ACCHL tournament, including an Admirals Cup in 2014. But you've got to look at these final four games of the semester, Duke coming here on the 19th. This could really be indicative of the way the entire season goes, and you've got to imagine you've got to find a way to take three or four, if not four or four, of these remaining games.
And you thought them coming back home after the two-game skid that they were going to be in front of the crowd again, they're going to be pumped, and they just weren't pumped. And then, so it's a little concerning going back onto the road, how they're going to react. Are they going to keep playing without any passion or energy, or are they going to get going, put some wheels on and actually score some goals, because they just have not had any luck whatsoever the past couple of games.
Well, here is the spin and the way we'll end this game tonight. The thing about being on the rumble strip of a losing streak is that you're still controlling the car, and whether or not NC State turns back onto the highway or veers off and into the ditch is in their hands. For Brett Gault and the rest of the crew, I'm Drew Blevins. Our next telecast will be on the 12th of November against the North Carolina Tar Heels right here in Raleigh, a 9:45 p.m. puck drop. You can catch us on 88.1 WKNC. I'll be joined by Nick Sinopoli Friday night and Sunday afternoon as NC State will be at Charlotte and at Virginia Tech. It's been a fun one. For Brett Gault, I'm Drew Blevins. Thanks so much for joining us. The final score here from Raleigh, the Wake Forest Demon Deacons 3, the NC State Wolfpack 2. This has been a production of Pack TV, bringing you into the pack. We hope you enjoyed it. I know we certainly did. Have a wonderful evening.